Hey, hey, we're gonna crush. No, we crushed the grapes. Now tonight we're gonna press the grapes. This is Mr. DiAgostino. Say hi to Bob DiAgostino. Hi, Bob.
Hi, Bob.
And this is Mr. George.
Mr. George. Nicosia.
Nicosia. He's another paisan over here.
Don't make fun of my hair.
But he's not gonna be crushing grapes or pressing grapes, right?
You're right.
You came just to watch.
I'm the inspector.
He's the inspector. He's gonna inspect the juice. And there's Bobby. There's
we got the gloves on. We're going to do the wine now so we don't screw up the hands. So we don't have purple hands. We're going to start, and you're going to go in and cook.
All right. Well, listen, here. I want to show you. This is, what year is this?
1933
wine press from Cherugi Hardware in Chicago, Illinois. And it is a double ratchet. That means you don't have to do so much work.
Wait a minute. No.
This is Ray Graziano.
It's a left-handed one.
It's a left-handed Ray Graziano.
He's doing it with the wrong hand.
Okay. Okay, here we go. Here's the crusher. Last week we crushed the grapes. And here's the brands we got. We got Crybaby. We got Smiling Baby. We got Valley Beauty. Okay, now here's what we do, guys. This is all the grapes. These two are Zinfandel. These two are Merlot Cabernet combination. And this is gonna make one 50-gallon barrel, and this is gonna make one 50-barrel. We're gonna take the juice out of here.
So here's the grapes. We crushed them last week, and now we're gonna squeeze them tonight.
It smells like wine.
Yeah, crush them.
Turn the light on.
Turn the lights on?
Metta la luce.
Okay, here's the barrels. These are whiskey barrels from Kentucky, charred whiskey barrels. And this is where you put the juice after we press it, and then it ages in these barrels. And this is a controlled room. It's 54 degrees all the time. So, now we got to get started.
This could take a while. This is modern technology, which has no part in the tradition of winemaking.
I can take a picture. What's your name, man?
Espiritu Santo. Amen.
Mambo Italiano, go. You mixed up Siciliano.
Okay, go. Now we take the wine out of here and we bring it to the aging barrel.
This old copper funnel has a little strainer in it.
Mambo Italiano, go, Joe. Shake like a Giovanni. Hello, quesadilla. You get a happy in the pizza when you mambo. Italiano.
Una nota bracciata con te. I made scatolin beans. You like scatolin beans?
Okay, the sugar content was both 26%, which is excellent. That's what you look for.
26. What does it give you? What kind of alcohol? Gives you half, right? Well, 13%.
Yeah, or a little more even.
Now we're going to be taking out the grapes. We're going to bring them over to the press, and we're going to squeeze the juice. And that is the stronger wine. The stuff that we squeeze out is the stronger wine.
Yeah, well, no! You're having the wrong thing.
The wrong thing. The sausage. Here, let me get under here. Oh, grab here. Okay.
Easy right. There with the sausage.
Yeah.
That's the wide part. Hold on, let's rotate it a little bit.
Careful.
Rotate a little bit. It's narrower here. Okay.
How's that?
Okay, that's good. Oh, be careful.
Easy.
Now.
Oh!
Attenzione.
Attenzione, alla. The way it is.
If this was Mogan David, they scraped that thing, right?
Yeah. Are you talking about the Jews?
Wait.
Man, he's a man after my own heart. This is my blood.
Napolitano.
Now, what you're not capturing, Pasquale, is the wonderful fragrance of the grape. I mean,
you have smell-o-vision?
Yeah.
Smell-o-vision, right here.
He kisses the grape. And all the bacteria in his mouth, here, we pick our nose, we put it in there.
Okay, here, wait. All right, wait.
Don't do that.
Where's the other bucket, Bobby, color like this?
It's a dark color, dark and cloudy. That's okay, because it means it fermented.
I think we need to press some of that
down. Right.
That's not going to go in there.
Oh, yeah, all the way to the top.
There's more in that.
Well, where's the school of bass? Come on, let's put some more.
Get the school of bass.
School of bass.
School of bass. Hey, okay, we got for dinner.
Hey, compadre, ci vuoi andare? Chi si sono fiscaletto? E come si sono un fiscaletto? Un fiscaletto, tipidi, tipidi, da.
Hey, compadre.
These blocks, when compressed with the gear, start to squeeze the grape down, and this is geared.
This is a top plate.
So, all right,
we're full with the must, right? We put the top plate on. On the top plate, we put these blocks.
We're going to get some more.
Oh, okay. We're going to get some more in there.
Get a couple more.
Got to keep this above this.
Exactly.
Here, you take a look at this.
We don't have a donkey. We have him.
Oh, yeah. Wait, fine.
The donkey got the day off.
Get this over here.
See the juice coming out.
Yeah, right.
We gotta get it over.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, okay, hold those.
Gamba, that's the skinniest guy doing the hardest work. I don't understand
you. See, after a while, you're gonna need more leverage. That's why that pole comes
in. All leverage.
Now, you see how it's dripping down out of the basin?
Now this is where you're squeezing out the pulp, where the character of the grape comes out.
That's right. The strength.
All the characters are squeezing out.
The characters. Oh, don't go taking no picture of me with the wine. This is last year's wine. I'm just bringing it over to the guys. So it's an important part of the winemaking process.
We're checking the acoustics of the blocks, because if the acoustics of the blocks are not right, the wine is
won't sing.
The wine won't sing.
We need about three more buckets full.
Whoa.
And we'll fill that barrel. So we're going to get it out of here, whether by hook or by crook, right?
That's right.
And then what do you do with the grapes?
Oh, the leftover grapes?
At the very end, you can spread it on your lawn.
They're actually a fertilizer.
Yeah.
So we're.
But we don't give up on it easy.
We're a sustainable farm here.
We're green. This is a green process.
This is a green process.
That's right.
We don't use any electricity for this process.
That's right. People can use different containers to age their wine. You can use French oak, you can use American oak. People argue about what kind to use. But we buy the barrels from whiskey distillers who char the inside of the barrels because it gives the whiskey the color. And a natural American oak gives a nuttiness to the flavor. So you get the char of the wood and the nuttiness of the oak. I mean, wine will taste one way going down, and then it'll impart something else on your tongue after it goes down. And if you use the barrels too many years, you lose some of that finish on the wine.
We're good at the barrel. We got enough in the barrel.
Really? In the Merlot barrel.
No, it's a Zinfandel.
Yes,
it's a Zinfandel.
We want to have extra left over because the barrel will breathe, and it'll breathe out some of the moisture of the grape. So we always keep a little left over in these bottles,
which you
put a block in the back plate.
And then
one of those blocks.
It's what's important to do is you pull the top of the barrel. And you make sure that you keep adding, because the worst thing you could do is have oxygen in the barrel, because it'll ruin the wine.
Oh my God, look at this antipasto.
Wow.
We got a little biscotti. I don't know what these are.
Every time you'd make the wine?
Every time we come here, there's more food. It's unbelievable. We got green tomatoes, pickles. Who made those?
Tomatoes.
Oh my God.
Oh.
Nobody here either.
Why? Pasquale's here, we're here, you're here, Ray's here.
Ray doesn't eat that much.
Who doesn't eat that much? Right. Oh, please. It's like American. He eats a lot.
These little bread things, where'd you get them?
Whole Foods.
Oh, Whole Foods. Mm.
Okay.
Green spinach, tell what is it?
Green spinach pasta. I'm not really
sure. Is that a marinara sauce, bro?
Yeah. And a marinara homemade from a patsy. You'll appreciate this. I did the tomatoes yesterday.
Oh, yeah?
So these are fresh tomatoes.
Wow.
Not from my garden. From all my friends' gardens, because I don't have a garden. I only have a pool. These are green tomatoes. Yeah. They are too, it's too late for them to turn real red. So my girlfriend picked them and gave me all of her plants. And then what I did was I fried them with what your father's eating over there. And you fry them with a ton of garlic and fennel seeds, black pepper, salt, and that's it. Taste them.
Hey, oh my God. We're here over at the Pastilli Villa Pastilli. And this is a villa. And we're having a little antipasto and some pasta and some pork chop. We're making wine.
Homemade jardinera.
Pasquale, here we are in the backyard of the villa. trying to eat.
The villa in Chicago.
We're having our winemaking dinner, which is a tradition now here. So everyone's invited every year.
You messed up there because everyone's gonna get bigger.
The bigger, the better. Yep, that's all right. We love company.
We need help for the question.
This is all about music, wine, friendship, and food. Right. What did I miss? Did I miss anything?
I
women, but we don't have any.